India is sitting on its edge. India's Chandrayaan 2 satellite is going to be facing what is called 15 minutes of terror when the lander goes in to land on the lunar surface. About half of the missions which have gone to the moon for soft landing have failed in this process. I have with me Dr. M Annadurai, the man who designed this process and who has lived and relived these 15 minutes of terror in his mind. Dr. Annadurai, tell us, the orbiter is going around the moon, the composite body is going around. What happens at that time and what happens in the next steps?
Yeah, once our spacecraft orbit is stabilized around 100 kilometer polar orbit, that has been seen, and full orbit determination has been done. Correct opportunity, pre-planned opportunity time from the ground command. Orbiter gives a command which cuts the pyros between orbiter and the lander together. So it lander goes away with the initial velocity of the springs. Between the, I think the spring is there, the spring gives an incremental velocity. Then after ensuring enough distance between the orbiter and lander has happened because of the initial incremental velocity, then the rover, lander will have its own orientation, will take orientation and have this 800 Newton thrusters firing such that it is taking the orbit from the 100 kilometer orbit to the 30 by 100 kilometer orbit. I think that's depending upon the time frame, the duration, other things are there. And typically it goes for an elliptical orbit around the moon of 30 by 100 kilometer.
So then at that point, essentially India will have two orbiting satellites around the moon.
Exactly. This is orbiter will be going around the moon with 100 kilometer polar orbit, whereas this one deviates from there and goes for 100 by 30 kilometer orbit it goes. And during the time frame, what exactly happened when en route to the moon, the systems are calibrated. When the facing loops, whatever we have done there, and the many systems like our gyros, accelerometer, the other star sensor, many things are calibrated in the orbiter. A similar thing will happen there. So now your lander also will become like an orbiter, and you have the capability of telemetry, telecommand, accelerometers, gyros, sensors, the velocity meters, many things are there. These are all the things can be calibrated, and the initial setting can be done. So many things are happening there. So then the correct opportunity, when by the time you can repeatedly going over the things, and your the other cameras or the sensors also can be calibrated. Then the correct moment, I think we are, the command will go to initiate that 15 minute terror, whatever.
So this would happen on the far side of the moon or the near side of the moon when the command is given that, here, Vikram, please go and land on the lunar surface.
No, commanding capability is available from the ground only when you are the near side of the moon. And notwithstanding that, it will more like an understep of orbit happening there. We'll able to do the things much better. But notwithstanding that, once the command is given, means it is like our Mangalyaan. You are preloading the commands. So what is the velocity factor you are expecting, and what is the acceleration you are expecting? So these are all the things are predefined commands are loaded there, and they're given the initiation for the autonomous activity to initiate.
So what would be the approximate velocity of the lander when it is going around at this time, when before it is given the command to go down?
Yeah, to start with, it will be somewhere around 1 kilometer per second. So that could have 1 kilometer per second is.
Which is how many kilometers per hour?
It is 3600 kilometers per hour.
That's really fast.
Really fast. That's really, really fast. But finally, that has to be zeroed down to a zero when we are landing on the moon. Its horizontal velocity should be as minimal as zero, and the vertical velocity also it's a near zero. So but those system is capable of taking nearly vertical fall of more than 1 meter per second. The systems are capable of that, but we should reduce as minimal as possible.
So 36,000 kilometers per hour, then it has to be brake to zero, and all of it in 15 minutes?
Yeah. It is for that the unique 5 800 Newton thrusters. Okay, you look at here, all the insats which we carried to the geostationary orbit, even to the few tonners of the satellites, whatever you've taken, is a 440 Newton thrusters we carried. But now in this mission, we have 800 Newton thrusters of 5 numbers. Okay, that means a 10 times more thrust, nearly 10 times more thrust capability of our conventional INSAT mission through this is in a place. And that means in a quick turnaround time, this thrust versus mass, that much you can decelerate.
And we have to use thrusters because there is no atmosphere and you cannot use parachutes?
Exactly, because unlike in the Mars or Earth, you are coming there, you can landing, you can have, using atmospheric thing, you can have the parachutes. But we don't have a well-defined atmosphere, very, very tenuous atmosphere that cannot be used aerodynamically to have the parachutes point of view. So you have to reduce the thrust, reduce the velocity by active means. That means using a mass expulsion, a thruster only.
So what happens? How do you start braking? Because from 36,000 kilometers per hour, it would take some effort to reduce the velocity. How do you go about? Is there a step process?
Yeah, it is not a step. It's basically a profile driven. That means, as I told, already a profile could have been uploaded there. As per the timeline, things will be moved. That is, when you are keep falling towards that, and you are the number of thrusters what you fire. You can be X, max, max, all the 5 thrusters, or gradually keep moving down. Because when the mass is expelled, when the thrusters are using the fuel is going down, the mass of the vehicle also keep coming down. So then the acceleration profile also, acceleration profile when you are following, and then the thrust, whatever coming from here, need not be full thrust. It can keep falling gradually to the extent of 70%, 60%, 50%, like that. You can keep reducing.
So first we'll have what will be rough braking.
Yeah, first we will have the rough braking as per the predefined profile point of
profile. On the autonomous process, first there is a rough braking.
Yeah, exactly. It's a rough braking to breaking down the velocities to a level. And then we are going for the, from 18 kilometer onwards, you keep going for the profile is given for the accelerometer, the other things are there. Then you are controlling using the same thrust vector as well as the orientation. Both horizontal and vertical velocities, you keep reducing it, okay? And such that you, when you planned region, you have enough range. That means you have to, for the place to reach, you have to go that place. And by the time you are going that place, from that particular height, you should have reduced the vertical velocity also. This is a combination of the two things. In spite of the fact, you have the thrusters only one phase.
So what altitude above the lunar surface do you start the fine braking?
It will happen around 5 to 10 kilometers onwards. It can happen here, given there, but not. What is happening is depending upon the surface, depending upon the thing and calibrations what you have done. These parameters can be fine tuned. Okay, can be fine tuned there. Originally, we thought about 4 kilometers we can start there, but this has been modified into ups and downs of the things, terrains. When you are going around the orbit for the couple of times, this profile can be fine tuned there. It can be as high as 8 kilometers also possible.
So what happens at fine, when you reach this altitude and you have start the fine braking? What, it's the same thrusters which continue working, and what happens to the velocity at this stage?
Yeah, then by this time, some mass has been reduced there. This instead of going for the 5 thrusters, it can become a 3 thrusters. 3 thrusters possible, because this is basically the thrust vector. What is available is more than 4 ton thrust available there. 4K Newton available there, but that can be, you can be proportionally, you can reduce it down. One way is throttling the system down, but throttling also we cannot go below some percentage. For example, below 45% throttling is not advisable for this particular thruster as per the test, as per the qualification. So accordingly, you can fine tune instead of number of thrusters, instead of 5, you go down to 3. But always ensure that middle thruster is firing, because middle thruster has to be while finally when you're touching that, because to avoid any dust to come up, better to keep the middle thruster to keep firing until the end.
So roughly at what distance above the lunar surface would the velocity become very, very slow?
Yeah, very, very slow. It's 10 meter above. We expect when we keep watching it there. When we keep watching it there, we should be as zero as possible. Then with the only the middle thruster alone, you keep going down. Keep going down there. So then with the single thruster, if you go even one of the thing is you can, you expect, again throttling is putting together. One is to avoid the any possible dust to come out. And another thing is you reduce the velocity also slowly. Throttling as well as maintaining the this concern you can do. And another thing is this being the mission after the landing also, there is no reason keeping the additional propellant sitting there. So even if there is a possibility, it can slightly some lifting also possible, but keeping the single the thruster always on with that propelling thing point of view, you can go down slowly, and finally when you are landing, any possibility of this fuel polluting that region also we can avoid. There are multiple reasons why you have to keep firing the middle thruster in a longer duration.
So what happens? You select a site initially, yeah. Then both the orbiter when it is going around and the high resolution camera and the lander, yeah, will keep taking pictures and keep adjusting where we are going?
Yeah, exactly. But what is happening is we have uploaded the already the scenario, yes. Uploaded the scenario. When the fine breaking time, it is trying to match that.
It's a scene matching.
It's scene matching. Scene matching is done there. So when it is seeing the deviation, it has the provision of changing the orientations. Basically, you look at here, this using the same 400 Newton, an additional 50 Newton thrusters are there. With put together, you can adjust the track point of view. It's adjusting is possible. And notwithstanding all these things, finally, when you are going and hovering with the fully all the thrusters looking down, so there is another opportunity also possible.
Still, there's an alternate side.
Alternate side. That means still after going in spite of scene matching there, after the place where you're reaching there, you are seeing the boulders greater than the 25 centimeter boulder size. Then there is the legs, any one of the legs should not.
It should not be inclined.
It should not be inclined, and it should not land on that, make it to topple. So that's also one of the reasons why very many landers failure. One of the reason being there. So the another additional provision is given. In spite of all these things, you have gone there. After reaching there, hovering of 10 seconds is allowed. When you are doing that hovering, you see that, and you can move during that time with the available fuel. You can horizontally move. And horizontally move and land a safe place possibility existing for this particular lander, keeping in mind what happens elsewhere to avoid such eventuality, even though you have matched the scene and reached the place. And finally, when your finder cameras indicates you have the boulders of a heavier size, you have the capability to go horizontally other side and land.
So you planned for many exigencies.
It has to be done there because it's because this particular final landing is a very, very crucial place, because that's a do or die situation. So you have to ensure that all the possible capabilities within you have been exercised there, and that's what one of the reasons why very many tests have been done, and the test feedbacks have been put in here, and making sure that we have any one of the eventualities of this type is not happening there. Actually, this is one of the way we have succeeded in the Mangalyaan mission. Okay, and you know that before Mangalyaan, nearly 51 missions have gone to the moon, only 21 succeeded. That means that 30 recent failure was there. All the things you plugged in Mangalyaan mission, that's how we could succeed
in Mangalyaan.
Exactly.
In the first go.
Exactly. So that's why here also, I think the attempt is to make sure that in the first attempt, we will succeed on that. So towards that, all the possible exigencies have been addressed, and accordingly, the autonomy has been programmed to the system. Required sensors have been put, thrusters capabilities of given there, and enough propellant has been given. That's the reason Mark 3 has come, and simulated terrains have been made in Karnataka. We made a terrain facility.
Chitradurga,
we making craters of similar thing what happened there, and here like your The aeroplanes flying there and putting the sensors, the navigation softwares as well as sensors have been tested there. So all the things putting together, I think probably we have the good amount of confidence, a good amount of testings, a good amount of hardwares, and good amount of autonomy built in there. So things should happen.
You spoke of autonomy. So once the command is given to the Vikram lander, which is named after Vikram Sarabhai in his centenary year. Yeah. Does anybody have any control?
I think there is no possibility of a controlling, because it's going in a very, very sequence, and each instant you look at here, each second some activity or other has to happen. Okay, that is the profile, it's whatever it's going to happen there. So it is more like another launch vehicle. Launch vehicle puts the satellite 15-20 minutes into the orbit. There is no command which no commanding is possible. Nobody is done like that. This is a reverse of the launch vehicle. So this is already in the orbit. It has to land in a correct targeted place. So it is almost like another launch vehicle. There is no commanding facility. It's prudent to have a commanding facility there. So accordingly, it is also not there. But still, the autonomy has to work. All the sensors have to work. Actuator has to work. And it has to, the scene matching has to work. So that way, I think it should be an all-round autonomy. Systems have to work flawlessly.
So your teams who have made this will, in those 15, 16 minutes, 17 minutes, sit back and see what is happening. That's why they are called 15 minutes of terror.
Yeah, I think this is a thing you look at here, almost similar thing coin was made when the JPL's Mars touchdown
yes.
It has happened.
Curiosity
was there. I think the same thing at there when our Yelachi came and flew down in ISAC. Yes, that is the thing movie has shown there. So I think it's more than the terror, because so many years of working of so many people toiling that so many days and nights, and the 15 minutes it's going to decide. So it's a really, really terror, and hopefully that eventually that terror has to become very, very sweet memories we should carry. That should happen like that.
So let's assume that the lander has found the right place. It has sat down on the lunar surface on an even plane. What happens next?
Yeah, once it has landed in a reasonably good even place, there exists a possibility of dusts could have settled there. Okay, the place would have been, the soft recolith would have been there because of the thrust going there.
And the dust when it settles on the spacecraft, it creates problems.
Because in the cameras and other things, it's a problem. There is enough capacity building is there for the solar panels are concerned, because enough margin is built there for the lander point of view. But still, we don't want to expose the rover into that condition. So initially, the pictures will be taken, and enough time is given, couple of hours, then the picture is taken, and ensure the surroundings okay, that the picture comes to the ground, and ensuring everything is okay, from ground command will enable or the panel in which rover has been kept inside. All along, the rover would have, Pragyan would have gone along with the Vikram.
Yeah, Pragyan is in the belly of Vikram. It's like a little baby being carried in pregnancy.
It's basically, instead of, it has gone all the way safely from the Earth, all the way from the Sirigarikota up to landing the moon. And until that time, until opens, it is the backside of the one of the panel, more like a belly, it's safely kept there. But now this panel will be opened. So then it is kept placed in a very, very tight coupled condition. So again, there is a pyro actuation takes place there. And it is not a pyro, it's more like a cutter. That soft cutter is possible. So that cutting takes place there by enough time passing the current. Pyro, one shot it will do, but enough you pass the current and gets heated, and it opens the system. And
the ramp opens?
Ramp is already... Okay. Ramp opens and ramp comes down there. Okay. Then in the ramp also, the system could have been held rigidly. Our rover is killed recently, so that comes down, and of course it opens the solar panel also then. So with initially it can survive its own battery. So it has its own solar panel in stowed configuration. It opens it out there. Then it will turn towards the sun-oriented condition. So then it will be able to...
So how much time would it take for, once you put the ramp down and the rover is sitting inside, yeah, for it to, between the ramp and coming to the lunar surface, how much time would it take?
Okay, it is basically, it moves nearly 1 centimeter per second type of velocity only it moves.
Really, really fast,
yeah,
huh?
Yeah. It is not 1 centimeter per second, it's not very fast.
No, from 36,000 kilometers per hour, the Pragyan rover is now going to be moving at a princely speed of 1 centimeter per second.
Yeah. So because what is happening is we cannot afford to move in a faster rate because it can create a dust. Yeah. And here the, you know, don't have the air, not much is there. And you don't have the, the gravity also not there. And this system can create dust, and the system is not very high. And it's a bike, like a Jeep, probably you can manage, but it's a very, very modest 27 kg system. And it's only some around 25-30 centimeter gap only it's available. So we have to go slowly only.
So once it comes down below the ramp, what happens next?
Yeah, once it's coming, after it's coming down, actually the panel, solar panel opened, that will be tried to orient towards the sun.
That means when it's on the lunar surface?
On the lunar surface. Because the precondition is, whatever the movement is taking place, it should ensure the solar panel sees the sun.
For charging the battery.
Charging the batteries. Don't drain the battery. That's the idea, if it keep moving there. So that is one thing. And another thing is, then afterwards, commands are given. Basically, from the ground command only that operates. From the ground command, how many steps it has to move. The motor has to move. How many steps it has to move. Basically, the six wheels are there. Six wheels have six individual motors, and the six individual motors can be commanded to run particular speed. Each one of them is its own speed, and the way in which the speed you are modulated, you are driving or steering the wheel. That means from the ground command, the modulation of the speed of the wheels, it will enable the rover to move forward or come backward. Or
change direction.
And change direction. So all the things are...
So it's like you do in a tank where there is a...
It's something like that, but remotely we should do. But while doing all these things, this rover also has a modest autonomy. Modest autonomy in the sense, it should ensure whatever the commands have come, reach to them, its movement, it should ensure all along power is safe. That means solar panel seeing the sun. And another thing is, minimum, there is a duration... beyond which there is no command coming from the lander, because all this command comes from lander only to the rover. Then rover should assume I lost contact with the lander. I should go back place from where initially last I got a command.
So it becomes like going back to the mother.
So further it is, that means it should keep in memory from each step. What was the previous step? I think that is not only the place, it should know the path. In which path it has come back, and similarly it can go back to that path and ensure yes, mother is giving the, it is in the purview of the mother, it is in the
watchful eyes of the mother all so the watchful eyes of Vikram Sarabhai on the Pragyan rover to send wisdom and knowledge of moon back to earth.
I think that means Pragyan has the wisdom to be under the elders' view all the time, so that their guidance is there all along. I think the idea is the guidance is there all along. In spite of that, wisdom is to be with them all the time.
Sure. We missed one step. When you put the ramp down, at what stage does India's flag go on to the moon surface?
Okay.
On the ramp, I'm told.
On the ramp, this is painted. On the ramp, it is painted.
So essentially, when the ramp opens and touches the lunar surface, we can say India's flag has reached the lunar surface?
More than that, I can tell that the wheel moves. The wheel moves. I think we have the India's identity imprinted in the wheel. So it is more like people are seeing the beyond even national flag of US, Armstrong's footprints.
So you are saying on the wheels of the rover, you have carved a situation where you have the ISRO logo and the Ashoka Chakra on it.
Yeah,
so when it moves, it leaves a footprint?
It leaves a footprint. We expect it, because hopefully a few meters away from the lander, regolith will be soft enough. And when it's moving, negotiating those regions, this imprinting is possible.
So, like Neil Armstrong's footprint, which is there on the moon surface,
yeah,
India will also leave a permanent mark on the moon surface because there is no erosion there.
Yeah. Because for a long time, it can happen there. But we must say, I think the cameras are kept in such a position to capture that identity also. I think for a long time that would be kept in, because of course this is a modest weight. It is only 27 kg by 6 is the weight, but still I think the frigolith is soft enough. A few meters away from the lander, there is a finite possibility this imprint will be there for a longer time.
So from 36,000 kilometers per hour, we reach to a zero velocity when Vikram is coming into land,
yeah.
And then the Pragyan rover travels at 1 centimeters per second,
yeah,
and leaves India's imprint on the moon.
Yeah.
How did you design all this?
Okay, design on this means it's basically looking for the capabilities of the drive systems. This system is very, very compact. Originally, we planned for the 25 kg rover. The 25 kg rover, what it can accommodate for the mobility. So, 25 kg rover, some mass we are leaving for the instrument, so some mass for its own communication capability, then the mass for keeping it the power condition, then you are leaving for the mobility, how many wheels it can go. So, what is the wheel size of this is there? Then, all the wheels individually have to energize. So that means you have to, that much of power you have to give to the system there. So with the available power of the solar panel size, and what is possible for to drive all the six wheels together, and not only six wheels together, we must be able to modulate and able to get back and forth all the things together. So this way, if you look at here, very, very optimal thing, which will not overload the system, is coming out to be 1 centimeter per second.
So 15 minutes of terror,
yeah,
will it give you also butterflies in your stomach?
Yeah, that is obvious. It's anxiety cannot be, we cannot rule out the anxieties, because so much of effort, so many people efforts is sitting on that thing. But finally, that butterflies would come out once we see the India's identity put on the lunar surface unambiguously, then all the things will fly off in a much, much better way.
So that was Dr. Annadurai telling us how those 15 minutes of terror are going to transcend, and how he, who designed some of that systems, and how the ISRO team is going to brace and face those things. More than that, there would be over 1 billion people who would be praying that the lander and the rover and the all systems work well, and India leaves a permanent mark on the lunar surface. In the 50th year of the landing on the moon by Neil Armstrong, India attempting a modest effort of landing on the moon. But the 15 minutes of terror are going to be very trying. With camera person Suresh in Chennai, Pallava, Bagla.